In this video, we're going to explain to you how to perform a fiber test using the Psiber WireXpert. We are going to perform a one jumper reference, and we're going to use this reference for performing the fiber test. Let us look at the multi-mode certification kit, which you will get when you order fiber solution for multi-mode with WireXpert. You will find a pair of modules, which are capable of certifying at 850 nanometers and 1300 nanometers. A pair of test reference cards, which are duplex, a pair of mandrels, a one-click cleaner, a duplex mating adapter, which can be used for verifying your set reference, and some fiber stubs, which you can use to clean the modules. To start the fiber testing in WireXpert, plug the modules behind the WireXpert as you would do with any other changeable modules. If the unit is powered on, once you plug the fiber modules in, the unit will prompt you to restart the unit to switch back to the fiber interface. Or if you have powered on the unit with the modules attached, then it will by default boot into the fiber certification mode. So once you have landed in the fiber certification mode, I would like you to focus on the connection and the settings first. As we have highlighted earlier, we are going to perform a one jumper reference. As a part of the kit, you will have a pair of test reference cards. Let us label them as cable A and cable B. On cable A, you would find fiber connectors, the SC connectors on either end. One is colored in red and the other one is colored in black. Likewise for cable B. The idea behind one jumper reference is to avoid disconnecting the transmit end of the test reference cards. This is required for fiber testing mainly to avoid the inconsistencies in results. As long as you keep the transmit side of the fiber connected, you are more or less sure that you are not changing the alignment. And on the receive side, it doesn't matter so much, mainly because the diameter of the receiver is much bigger than the diameter of the transmitter. Once you have connected the two reds on DX and RX on either end, once you have set it up this way, let us set up the instrument for setting the reference. Let's look at this video to understand how the setup is going to look physically. If you notice from the top, you can see that the TX and RX is labeled on the module itself. Now, we will first clean the TX module using the one-click cleaner and also clean the reference cards before we start performing the reference. If you notice, because this is a multi-mode configuration, we will have attached two mandrels at either end, and always make sure the mandrel is on the transmit side of the module. Now the connection has been set up, and if you look at this configuration, this is exactly similar to what we had shown in the earlier diagram. The transmit has a mandrel on either end, and one of the wires of the duplex cords is left dangling. Let's set up the limit for performing a fiber optic test before treating to setting reference. Let us say I'm selecting a TIA limit. Here in this particular screen, I will have to enter the number of connectors and the number of slices and the maximum loss for each connector that I'm testing for. Please make sure that you enter only the connectors in the link under test and do not include the end connectors of the link. WireXpert always assumes, irrespective of the type of reference you're setting, 1, 2, or 3, that there are always going to be two end connectors at the end of the link and automatically includes in the optical budget calculation. So you do not have to add additional 2 or 1 links depending on 2 or 1 connections on your one jumper or two jumper referencing respectively. WireXpert automatically calculates that. Once you have done entered the number of connections inside the link under test, which could be 0 in the case of a direct attach, meaning you're running the cable from patch to patch, you proceed with setting up of the type of reference you're doing. Let's say you're doing a single directional test. In the single directional test, you are doing a test for each fiber in only one direction. So let us assume that you have two fibers for a link, which is typically the case, one for transmit and one for receive. You are going to test the transmit fiber from left to right, and you're going to test the receive fiber from right to left. And that would constitute a single directional test.
most of the end users would require you to do a dual-ended test using the remote unit. And if you are doing such a test, just click on the appropriate configuration. In this particular case, we are doing a one jumper test, so we're clicking on the one jumper with the remote unit. Once you have set the reference scheme, you can see under the set reference menu that you have selected one jumper, single direction, and the remote unit as your setting. Once you have done that, you are good to set reference. On the bottom right hand side of the screen, you would see a label called Tools, and by clicking on that, you will land up on the Tools menu. Once you're in that menu, you will see a button called Set Reference highlighted on the screen. By clicking this button, you would be able to set the reference of the setup that you have just done. Once I clicked on the Set Reference button, the instructions on the WireXpert will guide you automatically to complete referencing of the setup. Once you have confirmed that the end-to-end loss is less than 0.2 dB by performing an auto test, you can actually connect the fiber under test directly between the local and remote units and do a measurement.
Once you're finished with the setting of reference, let's go back to the original sketch. A normal testing would typically mean that a same end of cable A would be connected to TX and RX. In this case, I'm not going to touch my TX, but I'm going to unplug the RX side of the modules on both sides, and I'm going to connect black end of the same cable on the RX. So once I have done that, the sketch would look something like this. My cable A, red and black, are connected to TX and RX respectively. And on my cable B, the red and black are connected on TX and RX on the remote unit as shown. The other end would be left open, which is where you would connect your link under test or the fiber on the patch panel. So let us proceed. Once the connections have been complete, you can press auto test on both local or the remote unit and carry on with the testing. Once the auto test is complete, you will see the test results on both local and remote units. You will see at the beginning the summary screen. On the summary screen, you would notice that there are margin or headrooms indicated at 850 and 1300 nanometers, and the length of the fiber is also indicated. If you have selected any application limits or the network limits, that column would also be available, where you can see if the application limit that you have selected is a pass or fail. The refractive index of the fiber is also available for information on the same edit. So the number that is indicated on the right-hand side on the summary screen is the margin or the headroom. So that is basically the difference between the loss that is measured and the limit or the optical limit that has been calculated. If you want to go and take a detailed look at how much the loss exactly is, then you would click on the respective wavelength and it moves on to a detailed menu where it shows how much the loss is on each of the fibers. Since we did a one directional test, the loss is only measured from either left to right or right to left, depending on which fiber it is. So when we indicate something as a loss on fiber 1, the loss is measured from left to right, and the loss on fiber 2 is measured from right to left. You can proceed to saving this test result, and once you have saved this test result, you can export these test results using a USB thumb drive or directly connecting to a PC and import it into the PC software to generate PDF reports just the way you do with copper testing. I hope this video was informative and was educational enough for you to carry on with the fiber test using WireXpert. Feel free to drop any questions at wirexpert@cyberdata.com. We'll be very happy to answer them. Thank you.